Naresh, the prime accused in the murder of the 17-year-old Junaid Khan has been remanded to 5 more days of police custody. The incident that happened on a local train near Ballabhgarh roused the nation against cases of mob violence. Naresh confessed to the police on the 9th of June that the incident was a fallout of an argument over a seat on the train. The 30-year-old, who was arrested on Saturday in Maharashtra's Dhule district, claimed that he was drawn into an argument when he tried to intervene in a scuffle between a Delhi government employee and Junaid's brother. Apoorva joins me on the phone line. Apoorva, a confession coming in from one of the accused now.
Well, the latest that we are picking up in this case at the moment is that the main accused has now been sent for another 5 days of police custody. Remember, he was arrested on July 8th from Sakri village in Dhule district of Maharashtra. And he was produced before the Faridabad magistrate court on July 9th. And he was first sent 2 days police custody. Now, the police had again requested the court for another 5 days of police custody because they said that while they have recovered the murder weapon with as the accused pointed out, they also need some more time to find out some more details in interrogation and also probe further regarding more people who are involved in this case. Also, they're saying that they wanted to find out the cloth, the blood-stained cloth that the main accused was wearing at the time of the crime, which has not been found at the moment. So these are a couple of reasons that was put forth in, before the judge. After which the court sent him for another 5 days of police custody. Now, the next date of hearing has been set for July 16th in the state. Back to you.
Apoorva, now the police has got custody for 5 more days. What else are they expecting? The investigations are going on. Are they expecting to arrest more people in the coming days?
Well, absolutely, Ashwarya. The fact that they had sought 5 more days of police custody primarily to investigate further and even interrogate this particular accused, because remember, he was the main accused who had stabbed Junaid and his brothers multiple times, and so they are trying to probe him further and find out more details about the other people who were also involved in this case. Remember Hashim and his brother Sakir, who were also grievously injured during this attack, had categorically mentioned that there was a mob of at least 10 to 15 people who were involved on that day. So right now we've just seen how 6 people have been arrested. There are, of course, more arrests that will follow soon, but that is all a part of the investigation. Now that they have sought 5 more days of police custody, we can hope that some more arrests could be made by the police, especially of the other people who have been involved, because we understand that all 6 people who have been arrested at the moment all hail from the Palwal district of Ballabhgarh. So we can see more arrests in the days to come. Back to you.
Apoorva, now this was a case of mob violence which took place in Ballabhgarh and it led to the death of a minor, Junaid. Now, apart from these arrests, what else is the police looking at doing in this case?
Well, Ashwarya, most importantly, they had restructured or they had kind of recreated this entire scene to get to the main accused. And as we also spoke to the SP GRP, who had held a press conference on July 9th, he very clearly mentioned that this was a very difficult case for them because most of the witnesses in this case did not turn up. As you understand, that the entire coach was crowded, but none of those witnesses really came forward and gave any kind of details or description, which took the police longer to nab the accused. Also, the CCTV, as they say, that they were only able to recreate that entire thing. The CCTV wasn't quite clear for them. So these are a couple of hurdles and roadblocks that they had to face. And the absence of concrete witness in this case, it became really difficult for the police to nab the accused. But of course, with the help of intelligence, with the help of other tip-offs that they could figure out, and with the help of Hashim and Sakir's detailing, they were able to find the main accused. Now from here on, it is their job to find out the other accused in this case as well, because there was a mob of 15 people who had bordered that court on that day from Okhla. Right now, we have seen only 6 arrests being made. And that is something that the family has also been time and again saying, that there have been a mob. There were 15 people and we've just seen 6 people being arrested.
Yes.
So a lot more work pending for the police. This is just one step towards the case being even solved, but it is of course far from being over, because most of the accused, most of the people who are involved in that heinous crime are still out. So it is to be seen when the arrest being made and what more details really tumble out of the interrogation that follows.